wanna be forever young. When he gets old, Oli now changing him to.
Old
now,
L.
People have Lil in front of their name. And then they now mature and then they be like, okay, I'm taking off the Lil. I'm
yeah.
Now. Would you ever take off the Young?
It's gonna be Young.
Yo,
if I'm ever gonna take out anything, it's gonna be L.
Oh, are you kidding me? What's it gonna be?
Just Young.
Just young.
Yeah. Okay,
just
great. Young. We have a Young L in the house. Great to have you on the show,
thank
bro.
You, thank you,
he has such an interesting story. I mean, I was chatting before we came up on there, but we're going to go all over that again.
Yeah.
How you doing, L?
I'm all right, man.
How's
I'm
it
good.
Been?
I'm good. I'm
all right, good. I was going through, you have quite an interesting upbringing, you know, growing up and everything for you. Mm-hmm. Just Plateau State and all of that. Medical
J-boys.
School.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
I was going through something.
I was checking out footballers that have come up. Bench Okpala, like Mikel, there are a number of footballers and musicians.
MI, Ice Prince,
J-Town.
J-Town should be Asha, a tourist attraction, you know, something
yeah,
like
that. It should be Niger's Hollywood.
It's a home of peace and tourism.
Whoa, come on. Yeah. All right, so let's talk about your upbringing, J-Town. How was it growing up in J-Town?
It was,
the music career and everything.
It was fun, man. I wouldn't trade it for anywhere. You know, I mean, it's so cool and chilled out. You know, I mean, it's not like Lagos where there are too many things to do.
Yeah.
There's cinema, there's beach, you know, I mean, there are clubs, you know, I mean, just, there's not much things. You just go to school and you find something else to do. Either you're a dancer, you're a singer. You need to pass out time because there's not much things to do.
Oh,
so
wow.
Either you're a singer, a dancer, you play, but you need to just do something because there's so much time after school.
Would you say that is the reason why we have more people industrial, like you have footballers, you have artists, you have people doing
I would say
other
that.
Stuff
you know, I mean, in Lagos, as I say, there are so many things, you know what I mean? Like you can go to the beach, Legushi, and just chill. You don't have all that. You know what I mean? Either you're going to school or you're doing something with your time, like either you're playing soccer or you're doing music or you dance or you do something artistic. Like you just find yourself doing that. So that's why the artists or the talent from Joss are usually a lot.
Exceptional.
Yeah.
Exceptional. Okay, so let's talk about, you spoke about school.
Yeah.
Sorry. Let's talk about it.
Yeah.
You were in medical school, but then you had to drop on because I know it's going to be hard to combine
balance
both of
the
them.
Two,
it's going to be
something.
Yeah,
one has to drop on. You decided it was going to be school. How did people around you take that decision?
First year, I already was a big artist in Joss before I moved to Lagos. Like I was like the number one artist in Joss. They literally had to tell me, look, just go to Lagos, give space for other artists to come out, you know what I mean? Just go.
Cool.
So it was, and medicine, I was going to my 400 level, you know what I mean? So I still had like 3 more years to spend, and it was tough, you know what I mean? Going to the studio, coming to do medicine, and both of them are careers that demand you, they demand your time.
I know.
So I had to choose one, and music is the one that I could do freely, you know what I mean,
without thinking, without stressing.
Reading this one, you know what I mean. So I decided to, you know, I'm going to music. My mom had to make me promise that if I'm going to choose music, I had to choose another department. She just wanted me to finish school, have a degree.
Did you keep that promise?
Yeah, I did. I have to, man. So I switched to accounting.
Nice.
So I'm in my final year.
Awesome. So you're a church boy, Young.
Definitely.
Why is it that the church is always churning out big entertainers? Not just entertainers,
I do want to ask
boys.
This, but after she's done, there's a question I'll ask her.
Yeah.
What we spoke about, I'll bring it in now.
Definitely.
But
yeah,
because you're a church boy, well, let's go.
So why do you think the church is a place where you would get the best of the best entertainers? Because I've noticed most entertainers internationally, they always come from the church. Don't you think it can come from elsewhere?
Me, I'm going to speak personally. Like when I hated going to church when I was growing up. Like church was just boring to me.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like I wasn't grown up enough to understand like what the pastor is saying. I always sleep off when the pastor is preaching. Like I always. So my mom had to push me to like the music department. You know what I mean? I was there and I ended up learning how to play the drums. You know what I mean? From there, the first music production actually was from the drummer in the church.
Ooh.
He produced me, like, using a diskette. And so that was, like, way back. Mm. I did the first song, my first ever record. So it was just something my mom knew I could, you know what I mean, just to keep me safe and still be in church. Like, just be in the house of God. Whatever you're doing, just be in the house of God. So that worked out.
I'm
thinking, no, floppy disk.
Yeah.
Ah!
Anybody that worked with the floppy disk means you don't think.
There's a major flag.
Yeah. You record with your
No, I'm thinking about what the future will be like. And some kids will be like, see this?
See this?
Like,
this is 2015.
Yeah, some people are going to be like recording with their phones and mixing it, you know what I mean, with the phones and release it on the phones.
Okay, let's go back to your story.
Yeah, so from there, you know what I mean, I started working. That's how I got introduced to MI, which was when I was in SS3. when I got introduced to Emma. Like, that was before even crowd mentality and before he moved to Lagos. Emma, okay. Ice Man, Jess, we all used to stay together in church, you know what I mean? So we started working together, do music, go. We just used to perform in Kefi, Bauchi, just places around us. You know what I mean? So Emma got signed in Chocolate City. He moved to Lagos. Then he sent for Jesse. Then Jesse sent for Ice. Then I sent for Young. Like, so it's just the whole, you know what I mean, we're whole family. So
wow,
that's how,
that's
so nice. Me, I had to stay back because I told him, you know what I mean, like, I had to finish school and stuff. Like, I had to get to a level where, you know what I mean, I can now, you know, juggle both. Because my mom was like, I always wanted you to be a doctor. So the least you can do for me is just finish school. You know what I mean? I know you're a good artist, but just finish school. And I tell you, okay, you know what I mean, I'm going to get to a level. Then I'll, you know what I mean? I was like, yo, you need to come, you know what I mean? I play people your stuff. And they're like, come, come, come. So it was quite easy. Like, as soon as I came to Lagos, my first song I did was Magician. Because it's not like I'm coming to Lagos and I'm like trying to, like, I already was in the game. Like, so, you know what I mean? I did Magician. Magician blew up. From there, I was on Iyanya's album. From Iyanya's album, we did Give Me That with Ice Prince again. Like, me and Ice Prince basically.
SOS.
Yeah. SOS, that's just title.
Okay. That's the one that comes to my mind when I
took a And all them naked girls.
For me. That's the first one that comes to my mind.
Yeah. Okay. So that's the story, man.
Okay. Wow, now, we spoke about. But you said you didn't like church growing up. Then how come you describe yourself as a church boy?
Because I found myself in church. Sunday, my mom, whether you don't have, we don't have, my mom is so religious. You know, whether you don't have food to eat or whatever happens throughout the week, on Sunday you're in church. Like, no, just know, don't even think about it. It's not like my mom be like, oh, today we're not going. Like, whether she has no money, we're going to find a way for somebody to drop us in church. So, like, I was always in church. Like, whether I wanted to
or not, so you had to be in church.
So, you were really, really glad to break free. Do you have any fan base in your church?
Fan base? Yeah, of course.
In your church?
In church. Yeah, I still attend church, like, till today. Like, my mom always, like, every Sunday, like, around 3 o'clock, I know my mom is going to call me. You know what I mean? Whether she doesn't call me, and she'll be like, Mimi, did you go to church today?
Oh.
And I'll be like, yeah, I went to church.
Yeah, sometimes you lie,
No, I won't lie. Like, I won't lie. I swear I prefer, either tell her, yo, I couldn't go to church, I had a show and I finished late. Blah, blah, blah. She'll be like, but still, okay, you make it up on Wednesday. Just try. You know, she just, because my mom, she grew up in Jos, so it's a very quiet place. So she doesn't know, like, what they happen. She just hears what people say. Oh, artists, you know what I mean? They're involving girls, drinking. So she just, like, you know.
And when she says so, when she sees your video.
Aww,
you don't blame her. Like, you blame her.
She just, I can't blame her. But, you know what I mean? Like, I was properly founded growing up. So I still go to church. Like, you know what I mean? Guess it's saying HIC. Like, I attend HICC.
So, yeah, that was very cool. They were looking.
Yeah, like,
so you were present for that. What particular?
I was in town that day.
You were in town.
Okay, but
I was in town.
Okay, but let's just digress a little bit. What do you think about it? That kind of Sunday church. What do you think?
See, I don't. As I said, I don't like to talk much about other artists. But I'm just gonna say this, you know, I mean, for the record.
Yeah.
I think it all has to do with the state of mind. It all has to do with state of mind. Like, I don't know what you mean by a gospel song. You know what I mean? There are gospel artists that still do stuff that are worse than secular artists. So how are you going to judge that now? I think if you sing a song and it appeals to you and you can connect with God, then it's a gospel song.
Bingo.
Oh, God, man. No. Dude, you murdered it, man. You just dropped. You slayed it.
You know what I mean? Like, if you sing a song like Timaya has some songs on his album. And for me, I think they are more gospel to me than when I listen to it. Typical gospel artist.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on what appeals to you. You know what I mean?
It's just that getting that connection to God,
just
right?
That connection.
Oh, cool. All right. So let's talk about your inspirations when it comes to music. Mm-hmm. Who inspires you locally and also internationally?
Locally in Nigeria, I know everybody says this, but I have only one artist basically that inspires me musically. There are other artists that inspire me, like, just life, like someone like Ice Prince. You know what I mean? Ice Prince is my friend, like, for about 10 years. You know what I mean?
Okay,
so he inspires
cool.
me. Am I? You know what I mean? They inspire me, like, not even musically, just in life, like making life decisions. Mm. When it comes to music, it's definitely Two-Face.
Wow.
Yeah.
Why Two-Face?
Yo, he's just, you know, I mean, the greatest thing to happen to African music.
Okay.
There's no doubt about it. Like, I always say it, you know, I mean, people don't give Two-Face the respect he deserves. No matter how you say it, you know, people say, oh, he's the best artist in Nigeria, Africa. I think that's even still
cliche.
Downgrading him.
Wow.
Yeah. Whoa. I was saying it the other day. Like, the only person I can compare Two-Face to is Bob Marley. Like, anybody less than that, I just think you're downgrading him. That's what I feel. Because I know him. Like, I followed Two-Face from day one. And wow. I've listened, I know all his songs, all his collaborations. Like, so
yeah.
It's an artist that I know, like, you know what I mean? The only person that you can compare him is Bob Marley.
Internationally.
Yeah, internationally, Damian Marley, Bob Marley, Kanye West.
Why Marley? What's Reggae? Up with you and the Marley? Like, Mr. Marley. Yeah, tell us about it.
Yeah, it's, for me, personally, and it's my personal opinion, I think reggae music is the best music in the world. So I grew up listening to, like I said, like, I don't have any training from like music school. Yeah, I went to Panam school like for minutes, but I got bored because I'm not good with the whole arranged, you know, settings. Like, I like things that are just free, you know what I mean? So I learned from listening to music, like in Jos, yeah? If you listen to a radio station in Jos, it's divided. On Mondays, you're going to listen to rock. On Tuesdays, you're going to listen to High Life. On Wednesdays, you're going to listen to like jazz. So that's how I grew up. Different. So my music is just like this. I listen to the radio. So you can't say, oh, Young L is a reggae artist or, you know, I mean, that kind of artist. Like, I just fuse it together.
Yeah, collect it, just put everything, all of that inside.
I was about to ask a question about that, but you've just brought the truth out. I was about to ask, what's up with J-Town Boys? Yeah. You guys just come with this new flavor. This new thing about your style of music.
It's just how we grew up.
And you guys grew up listening to
different
types of songs.
Like, I listen to the radio a lot. Okay. Like, a lot. Like, when I'm in Jos, I just have my small palito, and I just connect and I listen to the radio. So I have vast knowledge of jazz to reggae to raga to dancehall to afrobeat to highlife. You know? So when I have a beat, I don't say, oh, I want to make a highlife song. It depends, you know what I mean, how I'm feeling. But I just attack the song the best way that comes to me. So that's how, you know what I mean.
Awesome. That brings me to style of production. When you guys produce, it's unique. It's always unique. You don't find that kind of sound. Well, you find it elsewhere, but it's just it's different. So would you say the soundtrack, the production of the music makes the album, or it's the vocal or what the artist has to offer? Because when you listen to any kind of song from Ice to MI to the rest, just listen to the production. It's unique. It's different. It's strange.
I think it's everything put together: the vocals and the production and the idea of the song. Because when I know about artists from Jos, like we take music quite more serious. You know what I mean? Like it's a big deal to us.
Okay.
So you don't just say, oh, you know, I mean, let's just freestyle and just put it out. You know what I mean? You always like, you know, listen to it again, listen to it again.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like when Ice was making Oleku, like we were all there. Oleku had like 3-4 versions. The one people heard is the last version. Like, you have to work on it and work on it. There was a Fuji version. You know what I mean? Like, we listen to that and be like, try this one. You know what I mean? Try this one. You know, try this. You listen to it. The album, the same thing. The same thing with like SOS. Like, I play it, I listen to it. Same thing with Sugar. You know what I mean? I listen to it and, you know, I mean, change here. And that's how it just works.
Don't you think that would spoil something? When you add too much, it's like soup. When you add
it's not adding. Sometimes we even take out.
Oh, you take out.
You know, it's not always adding. You just listen and be like, this backup here, it's not necessary. Just take it out. Or, oh, you need to add a backup here. Like, so. But there's sometimes, obviously, like when I did the song Red Rose, it was just basically freestyle from beginning to end. And I made sure I didn't go back to it. I just said, look, this is my first song I'm going to release, and I'm just going to release it. Like, it was just a freestyle, and I didn't add any other thing. I just recorded it, and I just put it out. It depends on the spirit. And when I say spirit, people be like, ah, artists all say that. But I really work with the spirit. Some days, I don't record for 2 weeks. I'm not forced to go to it. Like, if I feel it, I do it. If I don't feel it, like, I don't force it. You know what I mean? When it happens, it happens. Like, I don't stress it. So, yeah.
Perfect.
Okay, so Looking at it this way now, you spoke something about freestyling.
Yeah.
Don't you? I feel that many artists that come out to say that this song was freestyle.
Yeah.
I think they just trying to use it for hype. Like, really, can you really just straight up freestyle and pop, and then you release it into the market? Really? Can really?
Of course you can.
I just would love what I say. I
think the word freestyle has been has been overused and, you know,
it's
dragged
cliche
to the mud.
Everybody now calls it freestyle because of. You do not do a style that everybody knows now, freestyle.
So, I mean, there's some, like, when I'm in the studio with Chopsticks, like, when he was recording Red Rose, like, when he was making the beat, I already told him, like, weeks before, like, I want to make a song that is, like, 2 minutes long. Short song. That is just cool, you know what I mean? He's just like, okay, we'll do it. And, like, 2 weeks later, he was just in his room, and my room is opposite his room, and he was just playing something. And he was just, you know what I mean? I just came into the studio, and I was just like, and that's what he does. When he makes a beat, he just be like, okay, just try anything. And I was just recording it, and he was just like, keep going. And I was just voicing, and I did it, and he was just like, this is it. Like I didn't write anything. It just
came out.
It's just sweet, you know what I mean? You just say what's on your mind and it comes from inside.
So maybe that's why some artists forget their lyrics on stage.
Yeah,
I know what you mean.
I think it happened to my guy once and said, it's just not supposed to be your song.
Yeah. Because you didn't write the song. You know, when you write stuff, you don't forget.
True, you know that.
But when you just say stuff, like you can forget. Like I forget when I'm singing Sugar and Red Rose, especially. Like, I forget the lyrics sometimes, and I just get back to it. Because when I'm recording sometimes, I just add some things, you know what I mean? And it just works out. We just keep it.
All right. Yeah. So now let's see. What do you have upcoming? Now, you just released the video for Sugar and all of that. Let's see. What are we to expect from Young Girl?
Expect new music. Expect new videos, collaborations, you know what I mean? I've been working behind this. I'm not the kind of person that likes to, you know what I mean, talk much. I just give it to you straight.
You're not so much in the news for plenty, people and all that.
You know, bad guy. Except
I said something about him.
Nothing has come out.
I'm a man of peace, man. I don't have problems.
Or you're too coded. Which one?
When I mentioned etc., I just made me remember something now. Most people now, when people have their take on artists, you know, there's no more thing. Everybody feels that everybody that says what you don't like is a hater. Do you?
Yeah.
I think that when you have criticism for your work, when you take it in the right way, you can make yourself better. But then everybody now goes like, if someone says something against me, the person is a hater. What do you think about that?
I think it's the same thing when you talk, how we're talking about freestyle.
Yeah.
How it's been used and it's been taken to the mud. You know what I mean? Like, people... Criticism used to be good, but now some people now want to use it because they know you should take it good. They now want to use it and make you feel bad.
Okay.
Some people like push it to the extreme.
To the extreme.
Some people don't, they might not like a particular song, but they just make you look like that song is the worst song in the world.
What's the worst thing anybody has ever said about you?
The worst thing anybody has ever said about me?
It was like, oh God.
Drove you nuts.
It was like, I think it was my dreads.
Oh.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah.
What did Messi say about
that? It's cute. Until the interview should be done.
No, I think you're putting on a cap.
And the person was like, that young, you should cut off your dreads or something like that. And I can't remember how he said it, but he said it in a way that, I mean, he doesn't have the right to.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day, yes, I'm an artist, but I also want to do what I want to do. You know what I mean? Like, you can't box me.
We're about to round up. Let's try and see if we can say something worse than that. What's the worst thing you can say about you guys? Just let's see. What's the worst thing?
I like it.
I'm telling you, okay, play a role. Now you're saying, try to say something bad about this hair. What's the worst thing you can say about this hair?
This thing looks dirty.
She has to be like sponge.
You did Chris.
Young L, how do people get in contact with you to know what's up with you on social media and all of that?
Yeah, on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook, it's Young L Mr. Marley, straight. YUNGL Mr. Marley. Like, follow me and, you know, I mean, just follow me and just say you watched my interview.
Cool. Okay. All right.
Young L everywhere.
Yeah, right. Young L Mr. Marley, everywhere. Twitter, Facebook,
Instagram. Are we rolling with this song? We should
do SOS. I want to twerk. I've never twerked on this show. I'm going to twerk today. Today is the day I twerk.
I do know. But if we do, we're going to run up with that. Thank you very much, Young L, for coming.
Thank you for having me.
It's been the Monday edition of The Breakfast Show. Thank you very much for tuning in. I hope you had a great time. We had Young L. Thank you. See you.
Thank you for having me.
On tomorrow.
Crown him.
Yeah, you can put it up. If you have the song now, okay, let's go.
Yeah, yeah.
That's it. We're just hanging out like that.
We should do freestyle now.
We'll do it in about ourselves. Okay, just hit, just go. Just go. Just.
Manatella say, SOS. Mr. Mali be the guy on the casino.
Twerk.
I beg you.
That's 18 years old.
Okay, I'll do the twerking.
No, let's go. Let's go.
Okay.
Mali be the number one candidate. I'm ticking like a bomber to detonate. New school vibe, man, I regulate to make the people to the gyrate.
To dance now.
From Baganda down to
the center. You ain't pushing blues these days now.
Everything.
Yeah.
No. You have to be in the center. It's your space. Allow him. Mr. Okay. Mali, officially, we're performing the song.
Okay.
I'm the drummer. You are the bassist.
Backup.
Okay.
Anything.
One,
okay, let's
two,
go.
Three.
Go.
I and I be the man on fire.
Mm-hmm.
I and I be the young Mandela.
Mm-hmm.
I and I be the man on fire. Mm-hmm. I make the people them a holla when I tell I say you.
S.O.S. Eh?
Mr. Mali be the guy on the casino.
You guys are not allowing me to dance now. I'm the one playing the drum. Come on.
You guys are crazy.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you so much.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Peace.